Coming to you straight from the Thunderdome in Cinerapolis, Force, Minnesota. We're ready for a good game of MFL football. But we're here with a team that literally eats their opponents, so we may have to settle for carnage instead.
Hey, that's what they paid for, Grim. I'm pretty sure they're okay with that.
And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Malice Hellboys take on the Purple Mutant Eaters. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, man, nobody can touch me with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, huh?
Hey, you bitch, I'm coming.
It's time to turn on, tune in, and get your mutant buzz on. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here. It's MFL game day, and you know what that means.
Yeah, the town will be in flames tonight, and half the city's population will be sliding down greased street poles and eating all-you-can-eat horseshit buffets from the curb.
Yes, victory can be bittersweet sometimes, Bricks. Let's see if the home team can light up this town like a Roman candle. And it's first and ten. In a fight between King Kong and Godzilla, the player on roid rage would win. Oh, what a run there! Touchdown! No one was gonna stop him!
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest! No, you didn't see it.
And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And he runs it for 4 yards. And it's first and ten. First down and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and ten. Oh, what a brutal hit! First and eight to go. Pass play nets them 7 yards.
Oh, no. I got the hiccups again. What are you supposed to do to get rid of them again?
You stick your head in a plastic bag, say the alphabet backwards while you set yourself on fire and jump out the window. It ought to stop them.
And he runs it in for the touchdown. Now, this reminds me of a lap dance I had by a skeleton once.
Oh, yeah. After the mayhem ball, that club 6 feet under. Yeah. Big trouble!
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim!
The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Second down and a lot. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. The coach isn't liking that call. Ho-ho, his head just exploded. Second down, and offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down in a mile. With a punishing hit. Third down and, well, good luck. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive.
Seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? You get my grill, I'll ruin your world. Ruin it.
And it's first and 10. He runs it for 3. Second down and 7. Well, that's a real buzzkill. He broke free and has open field in front of him.
Yo, man, nobody can touch me with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
And it's first and 10. A pickup of about 3 on that play. Second down and 7. Ball when your brain, heart, and central nervous system stop functioning. So I can't really blame this guy for the fumble. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and 10. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Second down and 7. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Third and 2. So the QB threw the ball away.
Oh, boy, they're going for it. This could get uglier than the baby resulting from an orcish family reunion.
The quarterback has had enough and calls a murder ball dirty trick to lay waste to the defense.
Hey, that
20. He's at the 10. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
They need a good return here to set up the... Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. He just got crushed. And it's first and 10. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this.
You can't keep a good mutant down.
And there's a huge gain, and this offense is rolling.
Margaret, that was a pass play. Rolling plays are in bowling.
Third down and 10. Finds its target. A pickup of 6 yards on the play. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he put all of his foot into that one. And he snags the punt and looks for open field. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? Now watch him stomp all over his opponents.
I want to take a beast boost injection too.
Now that is weird sight. Well, that'll trim your nostril hairs once and for all.
That was a nice piece of running, Grim. That's a first down.
And it's first and 10. Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10. Was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and 10. I'm gonna say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Second down and 7. Whenever a player gets big like this, it reminds me of that Tom Hanks movie. They get their hands up and block a pass. And that'll bring up third down and 7. Talk about Butterfingers. He should have had that one.
Well, I once saw a kicker make a kick like this with his extra leg. He used it like a golf club.
That wasn't a leg, you...
The defense calls a sticky ball dirty trick. The quarterback...
Oh, and he misses the kick. Man, his teammates are going to flog him when he gets back to the sideline. And it's first and 10. And they call a marquee dirty trick. This play is usually good for a quick score. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. The 10.
Holy mother of mutant mayhem, he scored!
You know, letting these dogs into the league is a slippery slope, Grim. First them, then vampires, then mermaids. Then before you know it, we're letting in cat girls. You know, things really start to get weird at that point.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And like a monkey trying to fuck a greased football, he gets away in a hurry. First and 10. And he gets 3 yards on that run. Second down and 7. One in for the first down. And it's first and 10. And ground game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Jong-il.
Nice hit. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with 2 in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
That pass play was good for 3 yards. Well, that's 2 timeouts burned, and you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate? Or are they in control?
I'm speaking from experience, Grim. But it really is hard to do both at the same time. And I have mastered it.
Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. 3rd grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just...
Hey, timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You gotta use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
3rd down and 5. Oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown!
In your pocket, Kevin!
You know, this shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's 1st and 10. picks up four on that pass and catch. Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first timeout.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
Second down and six. They call the warp speed dirty trick. Oh, with the brutal hit. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Yeah, same as Prince's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex. I took it as a compliment.
Just one. Just in some butter time.
Man, these guys, the quarterback just used his final timeout. Let's see what they come up with on the next play. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returner.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Was not going to drop that one. They need to call an attack ref dirty trick and stop this or they're going to lose.
Not like they need any help with that, though, man. These guys are doing fine by themselves.
Second down, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. And the defense gave up a lot of yards on that pass play. They'll need to regroup quickly. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? Our carnival? Huh? I'm going to go to our striptease show. Where are we going?
Greatest.
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's first and ten. Just follow the bloody footprints to the new line. A first down. And it's first and ten. And the defense puts one over on the quarterback with a sticky ball dirty trick. The only thing the QB can do now is run for his life.
Or die.
The way a rolled up dollar bill sticking out of flimsy Lohan's nose. It's a mare in Lost Wages, Nevada.
And it's first and ten. Oh, big catch! Big
that's no need for Brain Cram with a ball and didn't fall down.
And here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and ten. A pass that went nowhere.
That's like me at the hotel bar every night.
Hey, maybe you need a better opening line than you want to see the teeth growing out of the roof of my mouth.
What? The book How to Pick Up Girls and Tell Them Something Unique About Yourself. That's unique.
And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. Catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. First down and six. Oh, a vicious hit! And the ref will have to administer last rites. Funeral services to be held Monday at the Church of Holy Crap. Second down and five. And that'll bring up third down and seven.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
There's no reason to go for it here, but they do anyway. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. And it's first and ten. Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
And that'll be second down and four. Tire these guys out. First down. And it's first and ten. And that player just transformed into a giant. Good luck blocking this guy. Ho-ho. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. The defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball.
I love the murder ball dirty trick.
Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
10. And he picks up about 6 on the play. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. And he put all of his foot into that one. The return man catches the ball and heads upfield. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's 1st and 10. Now the QB is dinking and dunking the defense to sleep. 1 yard on that pass. 2nd down and 9. And that brings us to the end of the third quarter. They'll need to fire on all cylinders to make a comeback in the final quarter. 2nd down and 9. Oh, this guy just loves punishing the defenders. That's a 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. Was stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Second down and 10. He had it for a second there. Third down and 10. That's how you run it, folks. Picks up 8 there.
I don't understand. Why are they going for it, Grim? This seems like the situation where they should always, always, always punt.
Well, tell our viewers what... Oh, he just got crushed. And it's 1st and 10. The defender's 1 feet just kicked in.
He's so fast, he can run a kickoff for a touchdown.
And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the 1st down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the 3rd set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
More speed in game, and that's just a great run for a touchdown. At some point, they're going to need to put this ref out of his misery.
How about now, for instance? Here's a hit. Dirty tricks. Attack the ref.
They're back up here on 1st, and the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down in a mile. Six-yard gain there. That's a solid pickup.
I wish people would do solid pickups more often. I step in dog turds on my front porch every day.
2nd down and 1 mile. The roid rage dirty trick transforms a player into a rampaging lunatic for the duration of the play. I know that's typical of all MFL players, but this is different. Trust me. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him.
Yo, seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. It's first and 10. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. Second down and 7. And he catches it for 6 yards. Good mitts on that play, Bricks. His fingers are like a bunch of sausages. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. I think the defenders are scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah, he's a murderer!
And it's 1st and 10. It's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and 7. Nicely done for a 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. With the brain scrambler. Second down and 5.
Nobody can touch me when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about?
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It's good. Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
The offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career. And he takes a timeout here. They have 2 left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
And he held on to that one for a 1st down. First, a timeout is called by the quarterback. They have 1 left. And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast.
Why would they do that?
How many times do we have to explain it to you? It saves the clock, dumbass.
Second, that's it. That's their last time out. It's them against the other team and the clock.
Well, that doesn't seem fair. I'm going to throw a hammer on the field and even the odds.
First down! I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
Great throw, great catch, and that puts 6 points on the board.
The defense couldn't do anything to stop a throw that good, Grim.
You mean aside from bribing the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
I don't know.
Now there are are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
Straight through the uprights. Looks like they're lined up for an onside kick.
I thought they were going to do some sort of chorus line.
He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. You usually only talk about kickers when they win or lose games. Well, this guy just earned his paycheck, which is typically the amount the quarterback tips on dinner. First down and six. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
Second down and five. The Mutineers go home hungry and defeated today. They battled hard but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chimp dicks.
Did you just say choking on a bag of chimp dicks?
Yeah.
God, that was beautiful. Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy.